So. Mhm. Okay, auf dem Blasche.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
But what's with your water?
7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Is it okay this?
But what's with your
water? I was counting the bombs.
You're counting the bombs, eh?
Yeah.
How could you count the bombs, say, in Germany?
Yeah, but you can even count in Italian. Uno, due, tre, quattro, cinque.
What's with you, eh? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 8. But in Slovenia, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, eh?
Yeah.
But who cares about that? Yours.
Well, I can count in many languages.
Of course, eh? We can even eat in many, even in more languages, eh?
Yes.
The barbecue. So this is it. Should we start the video? Friends, salute and welcome to the Patricius Brothers RC channel, the channel where we will try to film and discover as many different planes as possible in our lifetime. The channel when we don't edit nothing from the day one, and of course the channel when we want to show you the meaning of this hobby, and that is to have the ultimate fun while you still can.
Hey.
Life can be so short.
Are you getting ready for the No Shave November, eh?
Yeah, of course, eh? No. This is what? So I look serious, eh? Like some really serious captain of the Flying Fortress or something, eh? But who cares about that? But what? You're distracting me, eh?
Hmm?
That's not the point, eh? The point is what I was saying, something.
Welcome to the channel, yes.
Yeah, welcome to the channel. Like I said, that.
Well, we were counting in multi languages.
Well, I was saying something, then you distract me. But what's with you, Captain Blush? The channel, man, I know that is it. Because I will just start to discuss. Of course, hey, if you come to this channel and expect the 3-minute video, then just go somewhere else and check for the 3-minute video, because of this channel we love to have
fun. You can check 5-minute crafts.
Yeah. You can check on the 5-minute crafts. Now that means that the video will be 5 minutes long, but on this channel we like to talk and we have fun for at least 20 to 30 minutes on each video. Because viewers, hey, if you know, have nowhere else to go, and if you're feeling down and low, just come here and have fun with us. And that means it's not fun to just come here for 3 minutes. It's fun to have 20 minutes of talking, eh?
Yes.
And in the meanwhile, we will see something, and we have something really special today. Don't come too close! Don't show nothing, because there's always a point. Now, I always make a story on this channel, I mean, I'm like a storyteller. And of course, if you see this, that means, I mean, we have here a new box, eh? Now, many viewers say, but why don't you just fly? You unbox the planes all the time. Well, of course, eh? If we want to fly the plane, we must first unbox it. And even the unboxing can be fun, and you can see what you will get when you will buy yourself.
Well, we would fly more if we wouldn't have this shitty weather all the time.
Well, viewers, the weather is not always good, eh? We don't have always the time. We do our best. I mean, there is always, after some unboxing, we also have at least one or two flights, and then still we mix the unbox video and so on and so on. But the point is that we are still having fun, even if we just unbox the plane. And even on the unboxing, you can see what you will get if you will order yourself that plane. So you won't be surprised, eh? Because the first joy for every pilot that buys RC plane is when you unbox it. I mean, at that point, you feel like a 3-year-old kid.
Yes.
And now I will stop with that madness, and I will start to discuss what we will see today. Now, of course, like I have said, we have here a brand new release. No, Captain Blush.
Yes.
But why?
Well,
why are you so anxious?
Then I will just zoom like this, eh?
Why are you so anxious all the time, eh? There is a point that I have this plane here. Now, I will be quick. Captain Blush, I think that you have already zoomed.
That's what she said, yes.
Well, yeah. I think that you have already zoomed on this plane.
Yes.
Because if I show you this, now viewers, if you didn't check the video of the unboxing and the maiden flight with this plane, well, don't forget it. You will have it later at the end of the video. You will have the link, and I will tell you what this is. A beautiful and sexy Skyrider from the Hobby King. Now, what's the point here? Now, in this range, around 800 millimeter wingspan, I think that this is the most scale little warbird that I have seen by now. Now, of course, for such a small plane, don't expect to have the landing gear on, because in fact, you can take the landing gear off and you have a beautiful and sexy little hand tossing plane. And even more, this time you can hand toss this plane because there is one beautiful and sexy feature in this plane, and that is it has the beautiful and sexy gyro already installed in it.
Yeah.
I will show it later. I won't show it now because it's not important, Captain Blush. But the point is that this is not the bind and fly plane. You can stuck whatever receiver you have on your radio in, but you already have the gyro in, which will help you even if you're the beginner pilot. Now, like I have said, it's a beautiful, sexy, small scale plane and such a good flyer that it hurts. Now this plane comes, Hobby King has already released by now, this plane in this shape, in this size. They also have the P-51, the iconic Mustang, which I will also get later. They have also released not long ago the Hawker Tempest, I think. Yeah, the Hawker Tempest plane. And today we have here a fourth release in this size and in this scale and with the gyro. And today we have a really, really iconic plane from the Second World War, from the Royal Air Force. I salute Royal Air Force.
R-A-F.
And what do we have today? The RAF. Look at this and be impressed. A brand new Hawker Hurricane.
Oh, plug and fly with orange flight stabilizer.
Yes, the same one as the previous one that runs on free cell. I will show you viewers later the battery, because all these planes, all the four planes now, because I will call this the collection, because this plane is the fourth plane from that collection from Hobby King, and they all run on the same batteries, and that is the free cell 8500. Look. 850.
Steerable tail wheel.
Yeah, of course, like this one, because this one also has the steerable wheel.
Wheel.
You have seen on the main flight, I mean, this plane flies so fantastic that it is seen.
Now tell some story about this plane.
Of course, the story, we have decided that every time we will unbox the Warbird, because we just love the Second World War planes, we will tell you a few facts and a few things about the plane that we will unbox today. And since we are talking here about the Hawker Hurricane, this in fact was, I don't even have to read it, this was the first modern plane, the combat plane with the mono wing, the monosexual wing plane with the single seat inside for the single pilot.
Well,
now the point is that this was tested, I don't know when, it doesn't say here,
but
this was tested in the 1930s.
And if I remember, it wasn't all aluminum, it was from wood and canvas.
No, the point is that from the cockpit back, there were still parts on this plane that were made, like Captain Blush said, from wood and from canvas. And in fact, this plane is many times we don't see and we don't talk about this, because they all talk about the Spitfire, because the Spitfire has become more iconic than this one. But to tell you the truth, this was the real workhorse from the Second World War, from the Royal Air Force pilots, because this was the most important plane during the battle for Britain. Now, can you imagine this? But they all now discuss about the Spitfires. That is just because of the media.
I think that you did your homework, eh?
Well, I hope, eh? And of course, Captain Blush, can you imagine that even here in our former country, here in Yugoslavia, they also had the planes like this after the Second World War. Anything else to say? The maximum speed of this plane was the 547 kilometers. The wingspan was 12
what?
Meters.
Ooh.
The range was 966 kilometers. And the engine that was running in this beautiful, sexy plane, yes, was Rolls-Royce Merlin. And it were made, they made around 14,300 planes, give or take 100 or so. So this is it.
Yes.
A little history of this plane, and now it's time that we see this for the first time. And viewers, believe me right now, pause, click on the pause of this video and click quick on the link below and order yourself this one, because if you're the
Well, first they must see them, eh?
Yeah, well, okay, but I can tell you right now, because from the experience of this one, I mean, this is not something to be missed, eh? And for this kind of money in the range of the $100 to get the plane with the receiver, the gyro, I mean, perfect. So that's it.
Yes.
I'm ready to see the first time. Because in fact, right now, at this point, I don't think that you have only one version on the market of this plane. I mean, that is how you can see that this is really, they really don't, it's really sad that they don't make this one in the 1.5 meter wingspan, but at least we have this one, and this you can fly in the back of your house. Are you ready to see for the first
time? Yes, I was ready for the last 10 minutes.
Huh?
Yes.
Now show first how the plane comes back in the box.
Very good.
And of course, with this one, I don't think that you will have to do a lot, eh?
Do, do this first, eh?
Yes.
Oh, look at this, eh? Wood reinforcement.
This is... But look at this, eh?
You don't need to cut...
If I look at this, eh? There won't be much work to do on this, but look how good it is packed. You can't break these wings inside, but eh, this is amazing.
Don't cut it, eh? It's a zip tie back.
I even don't have to cut with this, eh? Now let's see the rudder first, eh? And the great stuff, look what this, eh? The control horn, eh?
Yes.
Already mounted and with the screws, eh? Not just glued in, and even for such a small plane, eh? Do you see this, eh?
Mm-hmm.
And the one good thing about this plane's viewers, do you know what is the good thing?
What?
This is the small plane. It's almost in the range and the size.
We can almost say this a pocket plane, eh?
Yes, an OMX plane. But the great thing is that these are not so fragile. If you just look at it, it's already all bent and broken.
You can put it,
sturdy plane.
You can put it here in meanwhile, so you have more room on the table. Then we will put them together. And we will unbox it.
Yeah, of course, Captain.
Yeah, side by side.
And now, of course, we will see the wing. Now, I must be careful so I don't cut nothing, but I tell you right now, I mean, there won't take much of assembly of this, and I will tell you that, hey, I will have the biggest pleasure ever, eh?
Yes.
And I can't wait to see this on the runway. The Hawker Hurricane, eh, in this version and this size. I mean, this is amazing. Can we put this here?
Hey.
Now let's check this. Of course, the quality. Look at this.
Are the control horns already done here or what?
But what's with you, Captain Blasche?
Look.
Yeah, of course, viewers.
It's all ready for you just to
plug it in. Don't have to do much with these planes, but look at this. The lines on the wings. Do you see this? Look how scaled this. Look. And the paint job. Not some phony baloney stickers that falls off. If you just look at this and they peel and fell off. Look at this, good job done. Look.
Will you use a lacquer?
Yeah, of course I will. I will put the lacquer on so it will be really shiny. The servos already pre-installed, the control horn, say, I mean, this you see. Look at this, even here, the wood inside. For reinforcements, and you can see
now
here,
this is also for the support that the wings don't pop out.
Yeah, and this will be, oh, look at this.
One screw.
Good construction, eh? I mean, eh, look at this, eh? And really sturdy, not some phony baloney foam, eh? I mean, hey, I'm pretty impressed right now at this moment, eh? And of course, the elevator.
The horizontal stabilizer.
I mean, yeah, no, yeah. We can call it the elevator or the horizontal stabilizer. Let's see. This
whatever turns you on, eh?
Yeah, hey. look at this, eh? Of course, again, already pre-installed, and there's
this, eh?
And this time, look, wait, I will show you this, because usually when you have this on bigger planes, when you move this side works good, but this side not anymore. It bends much less, but this...
Yeah, do you know why?
Look.
Because of this wire here.
Yeah, the
connection. They made it a U-shape, so it goes to both elevators.
Hey. Oh, Captain Blush!
Pretty interesting.
Ooh, we have some goodies here, eh? Of course, we will take out this.
Yes.
Ah, like this, eh? A beautiful, sexy box. You even have The box inside the box for the more pleasure, eh? Can you imagine this, eh? Let's check what's inside. Look at this, Captain Blush. Da-da-da. Oh, the phony baloney fuel tank, eh?
Yes.
Now this will be some extra scale feature. This is amazing.
Some additional antennas.
No, these are the guns, say, I think.
This is
the antenna and the machine gun, say.
Machine guns,
oh, they go here.
Velcro.
They go here. There will be a little gluing involved here. And of course, we must check the wheels. Because, in fact, on such a small place, viewers, the wheels don't bother me if I see them in the flight. I mean, you can take off if you have the big grass. Of course, you won't take off with this. You will need the asphalt. But if you have the magic carpet, like we have on our runway, of course I will take off with the wheels, from the wheels, because it will look much more sexier. And even the wheels show to the viewers this. I mean, look how scaled they look. Tell me, Captain Blush, that they don't look scaled.
Pretty sexy.
Hey, for such a small plane, 750 millimeters, to even have the scale landing gear. I mean, this is perfection, eh? Now I will take it out like this, and of course the best part of every unboxing is the fuselage.
Do you know what is also the good part? That the propeller is already installed.
You don't even have to install the prop, and for this I will not come again. Now of course today don't expect the XT60, because I know right now the disconnector is, how do you call that, the...
JST.
JST or something, and now I will take it out. Slowly, gently, for the biggest pleasure, and we will have fun when I will take it out. Eh? I feel this. Eh? Hey, look at this. Do you see this?
Look how happy he looks. Eh?
Yeah, but do you see that this is the hand-painted pilot inside in such a small plane? Yeah, but don't show me. Show this. Eh? Look. Look how sexy the plane looks with the pilot inside. Do you see him?
Wait.
Do you see him?
I can see him, yes.
The exhaust, look at this scale exhaust, the free blade prop, even the spinner in this color, I mean, look, and these lines, do you see this on the fuselage? I mean, this is like the real, and this is the part.
Hey, don't get too aroused around me.
Yeah, but I'm really excited, viewers, I mean, grab it firmly, hey, don't throw it on the ground, hey, because then I will cry, hey.
Ah, this is this.
Ah, show inside, of course, you can see it here.
But where does the receiver go?
Yeah, I think that on the top, eh?
Huh.
This is the gyro that will keep your plane in one piece forever and ever. Do you see this? Yes. Of course, now we'll open it. Wait, Captain Blush. But I was saying, okay, check this. Because this is the part of the plane that was originally still made from wood and canvas. Do you see this?
Yes,
eh?
Yes.
And even here, look at this.
Now just open it because you're getting...
Hey, but this is...
I hope that there is a gun in your pocket, eh?
Now, of course, we must check here. I think that here is some compartment.
Uh-huh.
Oh! Hey!
Uh-huh. JST.
Look at this.
Uh-huh. Elevator, throttle, just the signals.
And for this one, because, yeah, of course, like always, you have just the... look at this, eh? But what's with you?
Oh, my God.
God bless, eh?
I sneezed. Thank you.
Look at this, eh? Small cables. Do you see this, eh? You just pop this in the signal, and that's it, eh? Of course. And here you have the flying mode. Now, It's interesting that because of this, if you want to use the gyro, you will need at least a 5-channel receiver. 4 is not enough anymore because of this. Because if you will put this on the knob...
Do you have such a small receiver?
You have an iron check right now because...
What were you using in this one?
What this? I still have it inside. Check it. Show it to the viewers. The beautiful, sexy Spectrum 6-channel antenna-less receiver, which, Captain Blush?
What?
Feel me?
Ah.
I have the second one here.
Show me.
Wait. We will show quick. If this, of course, will fit somewhere here inside, I will put it somewhere, maybe it always...
Yeah, you need to check where the battery
the front,
goes.
Of course. We will check, but look at this, eh?
What?
You have here, maybe I will put it here somewhere.
And we will see. You will see.
But of course, I will see.
Now show them.
You need the 6-channel
receiver. Put a plane a bit together.
I will put it a little together.
Because actually, you know what? This is 20 minutes passing now.
Already?
Yes.
We must be quick.
No, you don't have to be quick, I don't have to go anywhere, but...
Well, the most important thing is that, in fact, you have the compartment here that you don't even have much room to screw with the battery.
Where's
and
the battery?
That is why it's so beautiful. You will stuck it in here and you won't miss the perfect CG Elote. And that's the most beautiful thing, eh? Now I will put it a little together and, of course, show viewers with which battery I will use on this plane, eh?
850 milliamp, 25 to 50 C discharge.
Hey, look at this fit. Look at this fit. Hey, it fits perfectly. And look at this sexy plane right now. Hey, tell me that it doesn't look like a wind.
I think you will assemble this right now.
Because this is such a beautiful size for the Hawker Hurricane. Hey, don't. Right now, I will tell you again, don't wait, because if you will hold this in your hand, you won't even fly it. You will just buy this and put it in your hand because it looks so sexy.
Like a static, of course, I will like a static model.
Yeah, it would be sin to catch this one.
Some static models that are much smaller than this cost a lot more money.
Yeah, of course they cost, but this one, of course, you will need a little glue here, but that's not much.
You will know, why will you need glue?
Maybe not,
You don't need glue.
Because, hey, this is amazing. Now, of course, I don't have the instruction manual right now. But look at this fit. Do you see this, eh? This from the back. Now, of course, I think that I will put some glue in. But this goes in the slot here.
Yes.
And maybe really...
Just like... Nah, wait. Hey.
Uh-huh.
Like this.
Like this.
Yeah, this is it. Are you wet or what?
And maybe really, you don't need, look at this, eh? Wait, I must check this, eh?
That's it. Holes from here, from this side.
Oh! Hey, for this,
yeah, I told you before in the beginning
this,
of the video.
I must salute Hobby King, because this is amazing, eh? I really thought that I will have to glue this.
Yes.
That I will have to glue this together, but you don't have to. The wing is only the bolt construction. And here, look at this, you have the two holes.
Wait, I will zoom.
Do you see this, eh?
Wait. Uh-huh, two holes.
Yeah.
And that's it.
You put the screws in and it will hold the back of the plane. So later you can disassemble it and put it back.
Now put the wheels in and we will put them together.
Hey, I mean this
plane
is...
by beside plane.
Huh. Look at this, eh? Of course, you must put the wheels in. I can see right now that this is not enough, but look at the holes here. Do you see?
Two small holes for two small screws.
For two small screws that will...
Now put it on the table.
That will hold the... but this is sick block. Hey, look at this, eh?
Now move this battery away.
I will all put this all away. So we can see just these two beautiful and sexy birds on the table. I mean, look, go around and show the viewers this perfection. And I can't wait few days.
They look very, but they are the same scale, yes.
Yeah, I think so. That one is slightly bigger.
Yeah, but maybe it was even bigger in the real life, or wasn't it? I don't know.
Yeah, well, if this was 12 meter wingspan, I don't think that was much bigger. I think that these are scaled planes. Because the pilots, they look like twins. Do you see this, eh? Okay. They must be brothers, eh? Show to the viewers. Look at this, eh?
Huh? The same, just different.
Or at least some cousins, eh?
They are both green, just...
Yeah.
Maybe they are twins.
So they must be twins, eh? So what to tell at the end? This is amazing. This is amazing, my friends, eh? Look at this scale plane. Everywhere you look, it looks like perfection. Even with the wheels, they don't retract. But in fact, this was the previous versions of all the fighters from the World War, Second World War, were still developing. They were biplanes, and this, like I have said, was the first one with the single wing and the first one with the retractable landing gear, the working. Because until then, all the planes had the fixed landing gear. This was the first with the retractable landing gear. Now, can you imagine how modern this plane was at that time? I mean, this was really the workhorse of the Royal Air Force, eh? Huh?
Well, actually,
but it looks so sexy.
Well, actually, you know what? I'm thinking of something.
What?
Grab the plane in your hand.
What?
And tilt it. Tilt the plane.
Yeah, but what?
Show me the bottom. Aha, uh-huh, yes. I thought that maybe the wheels were...
What?
Leopardy is not
the
manager.
Because this is the support for the wheels.
Ja, ne smiješ tega Leopardy is not the manager.
No,
this is a prayer kulisa drugu stranu. Ja, zato sem rekel da barem.
No, the wheels were closing in the middle.
This is why I told you to tilt the plane so I will see.
And even the real one, they had this sexy protection for the wheels.
Because I have seen before that the wheels close through towards the out of the wings.
Hey, show it once more, hey. Show it once more to the viewers. I mean, look at this. Look. Look, when I will fly like this, do you see this? Eh?
Yes. Yeah, we will have to end the video, eh? 25 minutes, 37 seconds.
Viewers, it was worth it, believe me. Believe me, it was worth it. I will put it like this for the closure of the video, and of course I can put this one like this. What to tell at the end, I'm blown away this time, really, like I was blown away with this one, with the scale look of this one, I'm again blown away with the scale look of this one, and I'm not afraid that this plane won't fly good. If you will use the gyro, nothing can go wrong, okay? And I think that even without the gyro assist, which of course we will test, this will be one perfect flyer, like it was during the Second World War. And at this point, I can't wait to click, and I will click today for the P-51 and the Hawker Tempest, I think, eh?
Tempest?
And we will have, each time that we will unbox the next one from this sexy, what should we call this collection? The 800, the 7...
Less than meter wingspan collection.
No, this will be the 700 to 800 Second World War bird collection from the Hobby King, eh? Because this is the fourth one, eh? And I can't wait at this point to see the fifth one, eh? I think that they will release also something in the future. So this is it, viewers. Of course, we will stop video right now, so you have time to click on this one, and of course, if you already have it, to assemble it yourself. So this is it.
Yes.
Pilot Robert and Captain Blast signing off with another option for you to buy or not, who cares, but believe me that, hey, if you're a world bird lover, for this kind of money, hey, you can't go wrong, I will tell you this. You can't go wrong with this.
Yes.
How can you go wrong with this?
Tell you cannot go wrong.
If you have the gyro in, it can't be wrong. This is it, you will say. Click on something, have fun, eh? Thanks for your support, for coming to this channel, and just expect more, eh?
This is it.
Yeah, because we have so much more to film that this is amazing, eh? Viewers, this is amazing, and there will still be a lot of unboxings, but hey.
Yeah, you will say some more on the other way. Save something for next time, eh?
But even the unboxing is something, eh? Even this can be fun, because... But you can just post
well, when you're standing behind the camera, it's not so easy to film, you know, for half an hour.
And this time I will salute Captain Blush for being so good for filming my babbling in front of the camera, because if I had the chance, I would babble every single day, and I would just...
I think that by now we know that.
I would work on the TV or something, I would have the show, or I don't know...
28 minutes.
28, enough, viewers, this is it, eh? Viewers! Amazing Hawker Hurricane, amazing.